Greetings, grave robbers, and welcome back to the Stay Doomed Hiatus. Few things I want to talk about before we get into today's hiatus episode. First off, this is the last chance that you will have to fill out the Stay Doomed questionnaire. We're trying to get some data on where we're going to take the show in season 5, and we want to hear from you, our lovely listeners. So please take a look at the link down below and fill out the questionnaire. It's only a couple questions, and we want to get some feedback, so it'll be greatly appreciated. Two, we actually did accomplish one of the goals of the hiatus. We did, in fact, launch Plus 2 Wrestling, hosted by Scott Holiday, who looks like, sounds like, and is me. Scott takes some time to talk about professional wrestling, where you can hear his fantastic work on the calls. It's really, wow, that was really self-conscious of me. To call myself fantastic like that. In any case, check out Plus 2 Wrestling. Plus 2 Wrestling can be found over on YouTube. It's currently not really popping up when you try to Google it or when you try to search for it on YouTube because it's a new channel. So try to use the link down below and check out some Plus 2 Wrestling. And finally, this episode is our Rogues Gallery tier list. We really do enjoy doing these tier lists, and we sat down and we decided to rank various superheroes based solely on their villains. So please enjoy this bonus episode, and if you like these bonus episodes, consider joining our Patreon. We're currently catching up on some past due bonus episodes, but they'll be coming out very soon. Thank you to our very patient patrons, as they are in progress. But thank you so much for sticking around during the hiatus, for joining the Patreon if you're a lovely patron. And if you're not a patron, here's a little preview of what you could be enjoying. Thank you so much for listening. Take it away, Ust in the Past! Greetings, grave robbers, and welcome back to the television graveyard. We are your TV necromancers, Lara Prince and Noah Houlihan. We have gathered here tonight in the Crowdfund Crypt to rank various heroes based solely on their rogues gallery. With me tonight is Lara Prince.
Quote!
Very good. So, welcome to another Crowdfund Crypt episode. I know we've put these off, but we wanted to get this one out for you. This is a very special one. We are going to be ranking various heroes based off of their villains and their villains alone.
Okay.
So even if the hero kind of sucks, the Rogues Gallery could still save it.
All right.
The list was compiled by me and not told to Lara, so Lara will be learning about these as we go. They are in alphabetical order, except for when sometimes they are not in alphabetical order for some reason. And we are going to go through these and put them in one of these tiers. There's the cream of the crop. These are the most deadly and dangerous of the rogues galleries. There's a force to be reckoned with, which means they are still quite devious. Put up a fight, which means they're not too bad. It takes some battling to get through them. Pushovers, which means that they are not so great. And, of course, at the very bottom, we have Luke Tipple.
Does Luke Tipple still deserve this? Did he redeem himself?
No. No, he did not.
He was not the worst part of that shark rumble.
He was not the worst part of 20 minutes of television.
Apologies. Half-hearted apologies to Luke Tipple.
To Luke Tipple. So, I want to start by putting just a fun little cap on things to make things a little bit more interesting. I think Cream of the Crop should only have 5.
Okay. The other fun thing to remember is I will not be objective. There will be weird hills I choose to die on, and we're just all going to have to live with that.
Yes, yes. And I've chosen some strange ones, some good ones, some bad ones, so this should be good. And we are going to start again. This is in alphabetical order, so okay. We are starting with a weird one. And that is the Rogues Galleries of the Competitors of American Gladiators, facing quite the Rogues Gallery of Laser and Gemini.
I never watched Nitro. A single episode of American Gladiators, so So, I don't know. I don't know. Like, I have never seen an episode of American Gladiators.
Well, they hit you with pugil sticks.
All right, Luke Tipple.
All right, then. Luke Tipple it is.
Starting hot with a thing I don't know about.
It's in alphabetical order, and I was like, oh, well. Next, we have the very best, like no one ever was. It's Ash Ketchum. Ash Ketchum, of course, goes up against Team Rocket. There's also various gym leaders. And then the fairies, Gary Oak.
This is one of those things where I subjectively, really like Team Rocket.
I do love Team Rocket.
But they suck.
They suck. They suck a lot.
So
they
I guess really you'd have to say suck. Pushover.
I think Pushover makes a lot of sense. He does go up against, like, the gym leaders, but, like...
They're not villains.
Two of them are his friends, or actively his friends. One of them does try to throw him into a volcano, and one of them is a witch. But I think other than that, I think Pushover isn't acceptable.
Yeah, because I would actually say, for the most part, gym leaders are antagonists, but not villains.
Yeah. So Ash Ketchum goes into the Pushover tier. Now we have the international man of mystery himself, Austin Powers.
So we're looking at Dr. Evil, number two.
Yes.
Frau
Frobissima.
Fat bastard.
Fat bastard, gold member.
Gold member. Put up a fight.
Mini-me.
Put up a fight, because there's a couple times, like, they almost win.
All right.
And they've got freaking sharks with freaking laser beams in their heads.
Freaking laser beams.
And, like, there's a je ne sais quoi. The it factor of a villain. Of, like, I could just name all of those villains, and I don't think I've sat down to watch an Austin Powers movie in 10 years.
Yeah.
So, I think there's a memorable factor that I'm putting in there of, like...
Yeah, put up a fight. We could even see them maybe get bumped up a little more once we see what else is on the list. Next is The Dark Knight, Batman.
Oh, cream of the crop.
Yeah, I think there's no debating. Like, you have the Joker and Catwoman and the Riddler and Bane.
And Harley.
And Harley.
And Ivy.
And Two-Face.
And King Shark.
And Freeze.
And... I was trying to think of one we hadn't hit yet.
Kite Man.
Penguin.
Penguin.
Penguin's a huge one, we forgot.
Yeah, Scarecrow. Like,
oh my god.
Like, yeah, you can easily forget an amazing villain because all the villains are so good. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So Batman, I think, is going to be the one to beat.
I had a friend get extremely mad at me when The Dark Knight came out.
Oh yeah?
Because I made an offhand comment about Harvey Dent being Two-Face. Mm-hmm. And he yelled at me about the spoiler.
I did not know.
We grew up in the shadow of Batman the Animated Series. Mm-hmm. Not everybody, and plus we'd already seen Batman Forever.
Yeah, for real.
Like, I was like, dude, because this is a kid my age.
I do not know.
But yeah, cream of the crop, easy peasy.
This is a really good one that I think I might argue pretty strongly for. All the way from Sunnydale, it's Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Ooh, Buffy's such a mixed bag. Because it depends on... how you define certain people.
I mean, yeah.
I think what you consider Spike is really important.
Yeah.
Because Spike was an obvious villain originally, and then he had a face turn, and then, you know, he sexually assaults Buffy.
I mean, I think...
So that's not a hero
that's
thing?
That's not a hero thing. I would say Spike's relationship with Buffy is very similar to Catwoman's relationship with Batman. Like, there are parallels. I'm not saying it's perfect.
Yeah, I was like, Catwoman never essayed that.
No. But...
She probably did in some comic somewhere. Someone's gonna unmatch it.
Yeah, yeah. The Buffyverse is huge. But...
Oh, I meant Catwoman.
Oh. But, like, you also have Angelus. You have...
Glory.
You
the
have
master.
The mayor, who is one of my absolute favorites.
Oh god, and you even have like one-offs.
Yeah.
Like the gentleman.
The gentleman from Hush. Like
they're and in... Sweets.
Yeah.
Sweets is the musical demon, right?
Is that his name, Sweets?
I'm almost positive.
I was thinking of the Rupert's friend who showed up with the candy bars when you said Sweets.
Oh, the episode Bang Candy where he becomes like...
Yes.
Where Giles became hot and I became a woman. yeah, it is Sweets. Pulled that 20-year-old piece of trivia out of my bum. Oh, my God.
She technically fought Dracula as well.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about how most girls our age liked Angel or Spike, and I liked Giles from, like, 11 on. I was like, the librarian's cute! And my friends were like, what is your problem?
I just remember people being like, oh, Spike, oh, Angel. I was like, don't go for the vampires. And then Willow became a vampire, and I was like, oh, I get it!
Yeah.
I get it.
Yeah. I thought you were hoping they'd go for Xander, because...
Yeah.
I just gestured...
I tried to rewatch Buffy not too long ago and realized I identified more with Giles than I did Xander. And I was like, I'm an old man!
I always felt like I identified more with Giles than any of the Scoob. Early Willow.
Yeah.
I always really identified with, like, when, like, she was still, like, having her mom pick her clothes out and stuff.
Yeah. Okay. I could see that.
I mean, that's gotta be cream of the crop. Even...
I think so, too.
Just on, like, the... I mean, the gentleman alone.
I'm going to go ahead and put Buffy behind Batman.
Yeah, because for emotional reasons, I can't put them over Catwoman.
Now we have a very interesting one. We have someone who's been around for quite some time. It's Bugs Bunny. You got your Elmer Fudds, you got your Yosemite Sams.
I'm going to say they're in Pushover. Because how many of those can they still even show on children's TV?
That's true. That's true.
And again, it's a little bit like Team Rocket, like comedy villains.
Yeah. I mean, don't forget Algae Rhythm.
Luke Tipple.
All right. I'm going to put you in front of American Gladiators. Sorry, Bucks.
You just did that to yourself. You know what? Danny DeVito was in the first one, though. Put them back up to Pushover.
All right, back up.
Danny DeVito saves them. Because he was Swackhammer.
Yes, Swackhammer saves it.
And the Nerdlux.
And now...
Why do I know this?
I don't know how this person ended up after Bugs Bunny in alphabetical order, but here we are. It's James Tiberius Kirk.
Ooh. I mean, as far as memorable Star Trek villains... For original series, you're really... The big one is Khan.
Khan! So, and after that, it's Tribbles!
Yeah, like, it's interesting because Star Trek as a franchise has a ton of villains.
Yeah, because I was originally just like, oh, I'll throw Star Trek on here. And then I realized, I was like, well, that's a very hard thing to do.
Because I'm thinking of, like, I really, really, really liked... The Star Trek 2009 Chris Pine movie. I saw it 3 times in theaters.
Oh, wow.
Only once on purpose. The other time was at a drive-in, and then one more time I went to the Franklin Institute and saw it in the Omniverse.
Oh, wow.
And threw up in the bathroom.
Nice.
Because that is...
J.J. Abrams like his shaky camera.
Yeah, exactly. That was... Back when we were like, oh my god, they just cast Daddy Kirk as Thor. Mm. Because that was what we knew Chris Hemsworth was at that point. But I saw that movie 3 times and I can't remember the villain of it.
Oh, alright, interesting.
Like, I remember it was Eric Bana, but I don't remember that much else. So I think he's had a big issue with, like, it's Khan and the Tribbles.
Yeah, like, the Borg is not Kirk.
The Borg Q?
Yeah.
So I would say put up a fight. Because Khan and the Tribbles are iconic.
Do you want to put them above or below Austin?
Above.
I'll put them above Austin. All right. This is a good one.
Because I don't know that I could take Khan on. I could probably fight Dr. Evil myself. Yeah,
in fisticuffs probably. The Gumshoes. You don't know who the Gumshoes are? They spend their lives trying to answer one question. Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
So, we're just talking about Carmen Sandiego?
No, she has her other one. She had Top Gun. She had Patty.
I didn't really watch the cartoon.
That's from the game show?
Which I also didn't watch.
Oh, okay.
I love Carmen Sandiego, so I'd put her in Put Up a Fight.
Oh, okay. I'm going to go pushovers because they are always captured by children.
Fair enough. That is totally fair.
I put her in there for a very particular reason, which will come up later.
Oh, boy.
Now we have the Mighty Thor.
Ooh. He gets a big push because of Loki. Now we have not seen Love and Thunder as of this recording.
No, we have not. So there will be no Love and Thunder spoilers
here. Yeah, so like I don't really know about like the Christian Bale villain.
Yeah.
I will say Hela was a good villain.
Hela was great. Whatever that
Malekith
thing was in the second one.
Except Loki was probably easily one of the top five Marvel villains in the MCU.
Yes.
Easily.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have Thanos, Killmonger, then probably Loki.
And I guess we could also argue that this is every version of Thor. Mm-hmm. Like, we're talking about comics, and we're talking about movies and stuff. And if we're talking about every version of Thor, this would include, like, Alligator Thor.
So we
could include every version of Loki in this argument?
And I really like Sylvie.
Yes.
And I really, really like Alligator Loki. That's us as an old man, us as a child, and us as an alligator. So I would say Force to be Reckoned with.
I would say Force to be Reckoned with as well. That makes sense.
Loki really does up their standing
mm-hmm.
a lot.
We're now on to the Captain block.
Okay.
I got two captains here. I don't know how Captain Kirk got interrupted by Thor, but we're back to the captain block. They are not the captains you are thinking of, I guarantee it.
Yeah, you're not the best at alphabetizing.
It's Captain Hammer.
So, we're looking at Dr. Horrible and Bad Horse.
And Bad Horse.
Unless... I'm going to get real deep cut here.
Do it!
On the DVD release of Dr. Horrible,
mm-hmm.
they let you submit your own audition tape.
Yes, it's really good! Because some people did songs.
Some of them are genuinely really, like, freaky.
Yeah, there's a rapping puppet.
Yeah, the master... He actually, like, bothers me sometimes.
Like he texts you?
Yeah!
Hey, it's to me again. See
what's up. How did he get a Discord? But like, because he was like an evil, like, reverend. Because he does a thing where he goes, like, I'm the pastor of Muppets.
Not to be confused with the master of puppets. I'm the plush preacher, father felt, the pastor of Muppets. I'm the miniature, minister of sinister stuff. The priest made of ping pong balls, mischief and fluff. I'm the puppet of the Lord, and I'll tell you how to get to Blasphemy Street if y'all ain't gotten there yet.
Yes.
And I feel like I would put them at Force to be Reckoned with because of that.
All right. I could go over this.
But they're like at the end of Force to be Reckoned with. They could be dumped down to Put Up a Fight.
Okay. All right. Well, I mean, you also got Moist and Evil Thomas Jefferson, I think.
Is oh, my God. I forgot about Evil Thomas Jefferson.
And our other captain. The power is, in fact, yours. It is Captain Planet.
We recently watched some Captain Planet.
Yes, I love Captain Planet. I love the villains from Captain Planet.
So I put them in low Put Up a Fight.
Low Put Up a Fight?
Because, like, I mean, look around. They won.
Yeah, the fight continues. But you had the rat that was voiced by Jeff Goldblum. And you got Duke Nukem and that pig guy. And that computer that was voiced by Frankenfurter?
Tim Curry.
Yeah, Tim Curry voices the computer.
I don't remember the computer's name, but I remember it was Tim Curry.
So, all right, we'll put him in Put Up a Fight. This is an interesting one, and it's almost a cheat, but we had to include this one. The Survivors.
So this is Dead by Daylight?
Dead by Daylight.
This is so unfair.
It is really unfair.
Because that's... Michael Myers, arguably the Demogorgon, depending on what week it is.
Yes.
All of the original properties.
Yeah. So, the Trapper.
Freddy, Leatherface, Pinhead.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I feel like they have to be high force to be reckoned with.
All right.
Because it's so many iconic villains. I mean,
the Ringu.
Yeah, Samara.
Yeah, I forgot her name. The Executioner from Silent Hill.
Nemesis.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yikes.
Yeah. And then plus, the you know, got the Plague and the Hillbilly and all those good ones. All right, we'll put them at the top of Force to be Reckoned With for now. This one, I'm pretty sure you know none of.
Cool.
But I included them because, one, I love them, and two, so I could say this one word and see if you would guess who it was. And that word is Groovy.
Groovy.
Yes.
Earthworm Jim?
It's Earthworm Jim.
I almost guessed Ash, because Evil Dead.
Earthworm Jim had the fantastic rogue gallery of things that would threaten a worm. So it was Cy Crow, Evil the Cat, Bob the Goldfish, and then also Professor Monkey for a head, who had a monkey.
I'll put them in Pushover, just because I don't, like...
Thank you for not putting Earthworm Jim and Luke Devil.
I felt like it would hurt you too much.
It would. But when there's trouble, you call DW.
Darkwing Duck!
I loved Darkwing Duck, and I did no research before this, and I just kind of sat there and went, who were the villains of Darkwing Duck?
This is Morgana slander.
I remembered Morgana.
And Megawatt?
Megawatt, I couldn't think of the name.
I was like,
there's an electric weasel, and then the only one in the video game I could beat was the Jester, who had Mr. Banana Head as like a sidekick.
And then the yellow and black one, Negaduck.
Negaduck, yes.
And then there's it's a Megavolt, not Megawatt. I just looked up the exact name.
And there was a water one. It was like a Hydro Man stand-in.
Yeah, the Liquidator.
Yes. As much as I like Darkwing Duck, I think the fact that his villains did not really stick with us.
I mean, I named like three of them without really trying that hard.
Well, then where would you put them?
I would put them in low, put up a fight.
Really? All right.
I feel like I've been real harsh. I'm saving being a jerk until I need to.
All right, well, I think I see some jerk coming.
Cool, love it.
This is probably going to be a jerk roll.
Hooray!
Which is really mean because we got some real American heroes. G.I. Joe.
Luke Tipple.
Cobra Commander.
I don't care.
The Baroness.
Oh, Baroness. Low pushover.
Low pushover?
Because they were one of the few things that had like a capable female villain back then.
I could only name two. And then there's the one that doesn't talk, that's Snake Eyes or the other one.
Yeah, I didn't watch G.I. Joe.
I didn't watch G.I. Joe either. This is a guy that I recently got very acquainted with. And that's 007 James Bond.
I mean, when you have... This is one of those places of being iconic, because there's a lot of iconic James Bond villains.
There are. But I think the, like, you can do this at home, too. Think of three James Bond villains in your head.
Okay. Right,
did you do it? Was one of them Oddjob?
No.
No? Was one of them Jaws?
No.
Really? Who did you think of then?
Blofeld?
Okay.
Xenia on a top.
Mm-hmm.
And Goldfinger.
You know more James Bond than
I do. I was raised by a very different human than you were.
My feeling as someone that's not very fluent in James Bond is the iconic people in James Bond are never the main villain.
Xenia on a top was like a second tier.
That's Squeezy Legs.
Yes.
You know Squeezy Legs?
She suffocated men. Yeah. With her thighs during sex.
Jean Grey.
Yeah. In GoldenEye, which was one of my favorite movies growing up because my parents probably should have paid attention to me. Actually, I watched it with my father. Mm-hmm. Which, you know, not awkward at all. Because we used to yell, "I am invincible," anytime we fixed anything in our home. "I'm invincible!" If one of us fixed anything, that was the next thing you heard.
Yeah.
And you just see my mother like, "Why?" I married one of them, and I raised... and then we raised this.
So where do you want to put James?
High force... Let's put him in low cream of the crop right now.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to defer to you on this one, because I'm not very fluent in James Bond, but I kind of thought he'd end up closer to Austin Powers. Where's the next... Where'd he go? Sorry. I couldn't see him.
John
Cena. Brabado, it's John Cena!
I hate you. See, the problem is, in the time period where I was watching wrestling, John Cena was perceived to be the villain. Because I was a filthy, filthy smark.
Well, he has such great villains as Randy Orton, Edge, The Undertaker, a little bit earlier in his career. JBL.
Who I genuinely dislike. I
genuinely hate. The Great Khali, The Big Show. And The Miz.
You're forgetting my favorite John Cena antagonist.
Who am I forgetting?
The Second City Savior.
Oh yeah, yeah, of course, CM Punk.
Who I, like, adored in our early WWE. He was the first wrestler I kind of cared about.
Mm-hmm.
Was CM Punk. So, yeah. They're going to be... I mean, that's a veritable who's who of wrestling in the 2010s.
Right.
And I'm going to put them high force to be reckoned with because... Okay. And you know who was the linchpin? The Miz.
The Miz?
The Miz is a fantastic wrestling villain.
He's a great villain in fiction.
And that, like, that video package of, like, Hate Me Now.
Oh, God, it's so good.
And The Miz is also one of the few people who's managed to put out a t-shirt. I saw people who definitely didn't watch wrestling wear because they liked the shirt.
Hello, I'm awesome.
The Haters Wanted. The old ones love me.
Yeah. Yeah, Miz is great. Now, I can agree with that ranking there. The next one is a very interesting one because it's one you know a lot about and you also don't know anything about.
Oh, good. Love that.
That is the God of War, Kratos. And I know you don't really pay attention to those games, but his rogues gallery includes Hercules, Helios, Hermes, Zeus, Ares.
It's very strange because thinking about it, Ares is, like, the true big bad. Because he's the one who tricks Kratos into killing his wife and daughter.
Yes.
So, I'm trying... Is everyone else a villain, or are they just living their lives and Kratos is pissed still?
I would say... the spoilers for God of War. Ares dies at the end of the first game.
Good.
The next two games are about going after Zeus. Because Zeus was the puppet master behind the whole thing. And is Kratos' father. So Zeus is throwing everyone at Kratos. Including Hercules, the Titans. Like, Kratos kills everyone until he runs out of gods. And then he goes and starts dealing with Thor.
Yeah, because I know they went Norse.
Yeah, they went Norse later. So I know you love mythology.
I do.
Like, I gotta include a little bit of this.
But I'm actually thinking of putting them a little bit lower.
Okay.
Because they're clearly a super watered down version if a demigod can kill them all. Like,
I guess. I mean, he is a god by the end of the first one.
Because he supplants Ares and becomes the God of War. I don't like God of War.
That's fine. That's
just... So I just kind of have that like, ugh.
All right. Do you want to put him in, put up a fight?
Yeah, we'll put them squarely in the middle.
Right. And now we have Mr. Luke Skywalker.
Ooh. And it's interesting because you said Luke Skywalker.
Yes.
So that essentially limits us to Palpatine, Vader, and maybe Jabba. I guess you could say Kylo Ren.
Kylo, yeah. I was considering saying Luke Skywalker was the representation of the light side of the Force, but I think it makes more sense to just say Luke Skywalker.
I mean, I'm going cream of the crop here.
Cream of the crop.
Vader is the iconic film villain.
Yes. And then Stormtroopers. Boba Fett.
Yeah, because Boba Fett is... Does Luke deal with Boba Fett?
Yeah, he's not a lot.
Yeah, I was like, does. Barely.
He does. He's on the airship.
Yeah,
when
Luke
he gets...
considers Boba Fett an obstacle, not a villain.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so we got him in cream of the crop for now. We'll see what happens.
Yoda annoyed Luke Skywalker more than Boba Fett did.
Boba Fett. The Rancor. unfortunately, I couldn't find a good picture of this person, so I just have a picture of his actor.
Okay.
It's Mal Reynolds.
Captain Tight Pants?
Captain Tight Pants.
It's tough because it's not known for their villains.
Not known for the villains. As much as, like, the thing is, I love the operative. And I love the guy from the last episode.
Jubal Early.
Yes. Early. Early is such a good villain.
And neither of them is my favorite Firefly villain.
Really?
I like Saffron.
Oh, yeah, Saffron's really good. She got two episodes.
Yeah,
despite
she got
it on
two
Game
of
one
the
season.
13 episodes. Yeah. Good for her. But, like...
But then you also have the Big Bang. What are they?
The Reavers?
Yeah, the Reavers. And the Alliance.
Yeah. The Reavers and the Alliance, to me, are not... Especially the Alliance. Not great, but it's the Empire. It's the faceless evil government.
Well, you have blue hands.
2x2 hands of blue.
Yeah.
Like, I would put them in high, put up a fight, low force to be reckoned with.
Ooh.
You did limit me on Cream of the Crop, so I'm trying to be really judicious.
I mean, we could always move stuff.
Yeah, that's what I'm planning to do. I think there's going to be a race to the bottom. I've been pretty generous this round.
And now it's me, Mario.
Pushovers,
yeah. Really?
Bowser then occasionally just plays tennis with them.
You bring up a very good point.
Like, I sometimes really think about the idea that they are just all actors. Because, like, Bowser hangs out and plays sports with them. And they're all cool with it.
Alright.
They go go-karting together.
That you bring up a great argument. So now we have one of the largest rogues galleries, and that's Mega Man. Super fighting robot Mega Man. Each game has 8 robot masters with 1 power to fight. You got your Magnet Man, you got your Metal Man, you got your Proto Man, which is his brother, and
Cut Man?
Cut Man, he's a DJ.
Isn't there actually a Cut Man?
Yeah, Cut Man's from Mega Man 1, I believe.
Yeah, that's why I was like, trust me, I don't play Mega Man, so DJ Cut Man saving them right now.
And then as you go later, you get the weird ones. You got your Gemini Man, and your Pharaoh Man, and your Snake Man.
I'm going to say pushover.
Pushovers? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, there isn't really a truly iconic Mega Man villain.
Yeah, I mean, it would be Dr. Wily.
Yeah. Who to me is just great value Robotnik.
Yeah, you bring up a good point. And we are only talking about Mega Man, not Mega Man X. So now we have a group. Fighting crime, trying to save their world. Here they come just in time. The Powerpuff Girls.
You know what? This is going to be way higher than most of our listeners think it should be.
Oh, this is someone that I was like, this is going to be real high.
Subjectivity, baby! I like Mojo Jojo. Mojo Jojo is one of my favorite villains. Mojo Jojo is an antagonist whom I enjoy. Him is so fascinatingly subversive for a children's cartoon.
I want to do an entire video essay on him.
I could actually give you a really good source.
Yeah.
Because I've read an article about gender coding in villainy.
Yeah.
Through the lens of Disney, called Mean Ladies.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about how, like, gender coding and villains in children's media.
Right.
And how him is feminine coded to be unsettling.
Yes.
To an audience, especially a young audience. Princess Morbucks is a surprisingly good villain.
Oh, I forgot about Princess Morbucks.
Fuzzy Lumpkins is fun.
The Amoeba Boys.
The Gangrene Gang.
Gangrene Gang.
Oh my god, the Boogeyman? I was genuinely disturbed by that episode.
I don't remember the Boogeyman.
Blame it on the buggy!
And he danced or something?
Yeah, it was all... They made Eternal Night so that the monsters could party.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
I searched the Boogeyman and it brought up the wrestler.
Coming to get you.
Yeah, like... Look at him.
He's the Boogeyman.
Yeah.
That's what I am.
That's Cream of the Crop.
Really? All right.
Yep.
All right.
It might end up falling, but like...
I understand.
I am happy to be gleefully subjective.
We are now at 5, so any more Cream of the Crops will kick somebody out. The Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
I would say they are in Put Up a Fight.
Okay.
Because Rita is great. And then there's...
Zed is great.
Zed is great.
I would say Zed is great, and then they become a team.
They're married for a while.
Yeah.
And they have a kid?
I think they have a kid.
And there's also, like, they have... If this was the Henchmen Olympics, they'd be in Cream of the Crop. Because Babu.
Yes.
Goldar, Scorpina.
Yeah. Goldar is awesome.
But Ivanhoe's is dragging them down hard.
Yeah. And then, like, I remember some sort of, like, steampunk gear man...
Oh, I wasn't even thinking of the villain, like the monsters.
No, that was a Rita Repulsive replacement.
Oh, I did not watch that.
And then
part.
I think they fight, and then I think they team up.
And then there was always the peace conferences. The only things to ever successfully take out a Power Ranger.
Yes, they're constantly going overseas.
For peace conferences that they never came back from. Yes.
And then you got your putties.
Yeah.
And then there's super putties, which are invincible unless you hit the giant Z on the center of their chest. So what are you thinking?
I think they are low put up a fight, high pushover.
All right. I'll put them here for now. Ruh-roh in Scooby-Doo.
See, Scooby-Doo has the problem of, like, most of their villains are, like, Old Man Withers.
Or Old Man. Yeah, Old Man Withers.
Like, the only iconic Scooby-Doo villain is Scrappy-Doo in the James Gunn joint.
Yeah.
It's a Luke Tipple for me.
Yeah, I understand. Like, there's a lot of them, and there are people who love Scooby-Doo and, like, love, like, the villains. I know one of them's a robot, but... It's the same thing over and over again.
The only thing I see getting a lot of love besides the main characters of Scooby-Doo are the Hex Girls from The Witch's Ghost, but they are not villains. They are friends.
Mm-hmm.
The girl band?
The Hex Girls.
Yeah, like, you'll still see groups of girls cosplaying as the Hex Girls, and it's from a TV movie, or like a direct-to-video.
Is that what those were? I always just assumed they were demon hipster chicks.
Nope, they were the Hex Girls from Scooby-Doo.
Oh.
Not the hipster chicks from Scott Pilgrim.
Who is our next entry?
We are Sex the Bomb! 1, 2, 3, 4!
Oh, yes, I know them. I know, I'm looking at the Hex Girls right now.
Yeah.
But Scott Pilgrim's up next. This is a tricky one.
It's interesting because I'm thinking through the villains and, like, the first... Because you got to think through the evil exes.
Yeah, you got Matthew Patel,
who's got like a cool Bollywood number, but he's not.
Did you not read my name? Then you got
Lucas Lee.
Lucas Lee,
who's really entertaining.
Yes,
Chris Evans. Chris, like, when you look at the cast of Scott Pilgrim versus the World, yeah,
it's
film,
unbelievable.
It's an inconceivably stacked cast.
Then we got the vegan, and you could kind of say Envy is a villain.
Yeah. So now you first you were I was vegan, now you were vegan.
Vegan. Then you got Roxy,
who's probably the best one. I don't like how they handle her in the movie.
That's true. I love the vegan. I only read some of the comics.
Yeah.
But I love there's a fight with the vegan that's just a race through a mall, and they have to like resist the sales, and, yeah, like, and like Scott falls over and has a panic attack. It's the comic's incredible. But Gideon Gray.
Well, you forgot the twins.
Most people.
Yeah.
The twins don't do much.
Gordon Gideon Graves.
Gordon Gideon Graves is... Oh. He made me swallow my gum.
He's... this is a fairly middle-of-the-pack thing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Even with Negascott?
Yeah, I mean... It's one of those things. I really like Scott Pilgrim versus the World,
mm-hmm,
but I've kind of grown up into the point where, like, I'm really glad he doesn't end up with Knives, because I think Knives deserves better than him.
Yes, I'm cooler than you anyway.
And when you watch it as an adult, you're like, man, sure is. She sure is cooler.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of bits I love in that movie, but there's a lot of things in that movie where I'm like, oh, Scott's awful.
Yeah, if the music wasn't so good to distract us.
And the, like, and the other characters. I still go, Wallace! Again? In, like, daily life.
So, since we're only judging them on the...
The villains? The
villains, where are we thinking?
High pushover, because I feel like Scott has too easy... Scott dispatches them all so easily.
Yeah, I think if I read the comics, I might argue a little bit more, but... I didn't, so here we are. This one I can defer entirely to you.
Okay.
Sherlock Holmes.
Ooh. High force to be reckoned with.
Really?
Moriarty is the prototype of the supervillain. And, like, you can't rule out Irene Adler, the woman. She is such an iconic female villain. And she beats Sherlock Holmes. Irene Adler bests Sherlock Holmes.
Yeah.
In her only appearance in the stories. To the point where he just calls her the woman.
Hmm. Alright, we'll put Sherlock up high.
I mean, just, they prototype so many of the villains that we see.
Sonic the Hedgehog.
Luke Tipple.
Luke Tipple!
Robotnik.
Yeah. Sorry, Jim. Sorry, Jim Carrey. And Lyric. Your rise and fall. No, that's totally acceptable. Spider-Man.
See, Spider-Man's the other, like, big one.
Yeah.
Because Spider-Man's up there with Batman of his villains have actually had their own franchise.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put it at middle of force to be reckoned with.
Really?
Yes, because a lot... Unfortunately, one of the problems Spider-Man has is a lot of their villains do kind of feel like they are... Like, Black Cat feels like she is copy my homework but change enough so the teacher doesn't notice version of Selena Kyle.
Wow.
Like, Venom is interesting. Like, don't get me wrong, I like these characters. But how well did... The Joker movie do
compared versus to the Venom movie.
The Venom movie. How well did the Harley Quinn cartoon do
compared to Morbius? Not well. All right.
Like.
All right, we'll put Spider-Man at the top of force to be reckoned with.
Okay.
See what happens.
He's not moving up.
I think he should, based on what I'm seeing in that cream of the crop tier, but we'll see.
Fight me.
I'm gonna. I'm just saving it for later.
Supes!
I mean...
Superman doesn't have a lot of great villains.
I want to put him in low to mid force to be reckoned with, because Lex Luthor ultimately does become president.
Yeah, Lex Luthor is the cream of the crop of Superman villains. But, like, whatever's under that is a drop-off. Like, I know Doomsday kills him, but he also kind of sucks. Zod's pretty good. I like Middlix Piddlick. I think he's a very interesting villain.
Bizarro. That just happened.
That's a quote from a roller coaster.
It is.
All right, I'll stick him there for now. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. They're heroes in a half shell.
Turtle power. You have Shredder, and you have Krang.
You have the Foot Soldiers. You have the rock creatures from Dimension Z. You got Bebop and Rocksteady.
Bebop and Rocksteady, like, that kind of falls into you arguing about Jaws and Oddjob. Bebop and Rocksteady are the Jaws and Oddjob of Ninja Turtles.
Right, but my argument was that the henchmen are more iconic than the main villains. Not that they're not valid as being part of the Rogues Gallery for James Bond. And you proved me wrong. So,
I'll put them and put up a fight.
Put up a fight?
Yeah.
All right.
I don't care. I don't care.
The X-Men.
Ooh, the X-Men have such a deep bench.
Yeah, because you got your Magneto, which is like your top.
The X-Men are going to bump James Bond out of cream of the crop.
Ooh.
I mean, even just some of the weirder villains, like, get out of my head, Charles!
Yeah, the Juggernaut.
Yeah.
Bitch.
Mystique is a great villain.
Mystique is a fantastic villain.
Magneto is such a good villain. He can frequently convince the audience he's right.
Yeah, there's... With X-Men, they do such a good job with Shades of Grey.
Yes. And Jean Grey.
And Jean's Greys. There's like 50 or so Shades of Grey.
50 Shades of Grey.
Up next is Christian Grey. No.
Christian Grey is the villain.
He is the villain of that film. All right. This is not turning out the way I thought it would.
Yep. But
here we are.
Ha-ha.
You know, sometimes, some crimes, they go slipping through them cracks. That's why we got these two jumpsuits. It's the Rescue Rangers.
I'm going to be honest. I don't remember a lot of...
There's a cat in a suit.
The Claw. Like, Claw's the organization he works.
No, that's Inspector Gadget, love.
No, that's Dr. Claw. No, he...
Oh, you're right.
Yeah.
Dr. Claw works for MAD.
Yes.
I stand corrected.
Yeah, like, do not come to me...
I'm sorry. On
about
this, the day of your cat's quinceañera.
On this, the day of my cat's quinceañera. No, but, like, do not come to me about Disney Afternoon.
I remember there's some guy in a lab
Fat
coat.
Cat.
There's Fat Cat. There's a guy in a lab coat with an orange mustache. And that's really all I got for you. And then some from the movie.
So, yeah, I guess you can fold in spoilers. Aged Peter Pan.
Yes. So, pushovers?
Yeah.
Low pushovers. Now we got the hometown boy from Philadelphia. It's Rocky Balboa. He's got Apollo Creed and Mr. T and Thunderlips. That's Hulk Hogan. All right, I'm putting him in Luke Temple.
I've never seen a Rocky movie. I don't need to see a guy get punched in the face for 2 hours.
But he does a freight train.
Don't care. I know I'm, like, from Philly Metro and should have seen it, but I just, I've never seen a Rocky movie, and I don't care?
This next one's the trickiest one.
Okay.
This is, like, the wild card that I could see you arguing for any single tier.
All right.
Sora.
Oh, because you fold in Disney villains here.
Yeah, Sora's catalog includes the Heartless, Ansem, Clayton, the Red Queen, Cruella de Vil,
Maleficent,
Jafar, the big thing from Frog Mountain or whatever.
Chernabog, the thing that scared the living crap out of his child.
Sephiroth, Hades. What do you do?
I want to put them in. Who is in Cream of the Crop?
Cream of the Crop is currently Batman, Buffy, X-Men, the Powerpuff Girls, and Luke Skywalker.
All right, Buffy's moving down.
Buffy over the Powerpuff Girls!
I get to decide. I get to choose. Do we have any stuffies of any of the Buffy villains in our home?
No! You would... Oh, can I get one?
Only if it's the puppet from Smile.
I used to have that!
Yeah, I didn't make you get rid of it.
I used to have a Spike puppet!
He would have been welcome here. Buffy is the Matt Pat of this episode.
Buffy's not. Something I'm more upset.
I don't care.
So mad. So mad.
I'm not.
The Ghostbusters.
I'm gonna go, like...
This is a toughie, I know.
This is, like, pushover? Because, like, what do you have here? The Stay Puft Man?
You got...
Zool.
You got Zool. You got the Hounds. You got Slimer. You got...
Yeah, Slimer. Ends up being a mascot.
You got the Library Ghost. You got...
The Patriarchy.
The Patriarchy.
I was making a joke about Ghostbusters 2016.
Oh, yeah. You got... the guy in the Vigo. He is Vigo.
I'm looking at pushover.
Pushovers. He is Vigo.
They're iconic as, like, things, but not as villains.
Okay. All right.
Like, it's like, oh, it's the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. What evil thing did he do? Rampage. He stomped.
Okay. We got three more.
Okay, go.
Harold Potter.
Actually, his legal name is Harry.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, my bad.
So, you're looking at Voldemort, but you're also looking at Umbridge. You're
looking at Umbridge.
And, like, all of the Death
Bellatrix,
Eaters.
Yeah.
I would put them in Force to be Reckoned With just because they are very, very evil. Like, Umbridge is a villain that people say, like, if you put me in a room with Hitler, Bin Laden, Umbridge, and two bullets, I'd shoot Umbridge twice.
Yeah.
Like, that's...
Umbridge is a great villain.
She's reviled in a way that very few villains are reviled.
Yeah. I wish we had watched a little more of this before this, but the Venture Brothers. The Mighty Monarch!
I want to say pushover, not because they're... I don't like them.
But that's what they are.
But, like, the Monarch sucks as a villain.
Yeah, we got the Mighty Monarch, you got Baron von Underbite, and you have David Bowie.
And David Bowie is great.
And Phantom Limb. Oh my god, I almost forgot about Phantom Limb.
Molotov.
Molotov Cocktease. She's
Doctor Girlfriend.
She's the Catwoman.
So pushover.
Pushover?
Yeah, because they're too fun to put into Luke Tipple.
And then finally on this list, I think is this our only duo? Well, no, yeah, I think this is the only duo we have on the whole list. And that is Laura Prince and Noah Houlihan, the Stay Doomed podcast.
Who are our villains?
Well, we got Luke Tipple. We have Matt Pat.
I feel like Luke Tipple's been redeemed a little bit.
He's our Catwoman.
I was gonna say he's our Loki. He's like kind of come around.
We got Matt Pat. Matt Pat
is the villain of the Stadium podcast.
We have the creator of Heathers.
Oh God.
We have the guy's name I always forget from Shattered. The hell is his name? Every time I forget his name.
Yeah, but what's every funny time. Is like. They're just, like, I'd put them in, ironically, Luke Tipple.
Yeah.
Because they're guard, like, they're not, I can't put them up there with, like, Moriarty. Like, Matt Pat does not go out to ruin my day.
That is true.
He just does.
Yes.
He's, like, the Simpson to my Grimes.
He is the...
He just ruins my day without trying.
He is the Dr. Horrible to our Captain Cold.
Oh.
Dude, you are not my nemesis.
Yes.
All right. So now we're going to run through these and see if we got to do any shuffling.
Okay.
All right, so Cream of the Crop is currently full. Yeah. Is Batman's Rogue Gallery better than the X-Men's?
Yes.
All right. Is the X-Men's Rogue Gallery better than Sora's? Right?
No.
No! Alright, we slide X-Men down. Batman better than Sora?
Yeah.
Alright. Is X-Men's Rogue Gallery better than the Powerpuff Girls?
Yes.
Alright. Is the Powerpuff Rogue Gallery better than Luke Skywalker's?
No.
Alright. This is a potential...
Where's Sherlock Holmes?
Sherlock Holmes isn't a force to be reckoned with.
Oh, I kind of thought I put him in Cream of the Crop for some reason.
No. You put him in the middle of force to be reckoned with, and then he got shuffled back. He'll show up, and I think probably...
He's going to probably move up.
He'll make some strides, I think. I don't know.
Oh, he's probably going to move up.
Are you really going to sit there?
Yeah.
And tell me that the Powerpuff yes. Girls Rose Gallery... is better than Spider-Man's.
Yes.
How? How are you going to say that to me?
Easy. The Powerpuff Girls... You're not looking at me. It's very rude, Noah. The Powerpuff Girls Rogues Gallery is better than Spider-Man's.
Where's the reasoning?
They are a brilliant satire... of existing superhero tropes in a way that so much of the Spider-Man Rogues Gallery is, like I said before, copying Batman's homework and changing just enough.
Then,
yeah?
Dr. Octopus, Kingpin.
Yeah, they're at the height of force to be reckoned with. Hey, who put the arbitrary 5 limit on there?
I don't like how these bonus episodes have become you scolding me for ideas I had.
I'm not scolding you. I'm scolding you for putting a limitation on a thing and then complaining when you don't get your way with your limitation that you put on here.
Okay.
If you allowed 6 to be in Cream of the Crop, I might have had Spider-Man up there.
All right, so if we bump this to 6... I can move up Spider-Man.
Maybe.
No, I'm asking you right now.
No.
What do you mean?
I want to see who's in force to be reckoned with.
Spider-Man versus Buffy.
Spider-Man.
Okay. Buffy versus Harry Potter.
Harry Potter.
Yeah.
And it's interesting, Buffy versus Harry Potter. Fallen problematic creator plant.
Yeah.
This is the fallen problematic creator section.
Buffy versus James Bond? You're more into Bond than me, so I have to defer to you, but I'm really into Buffy, so I'm going to yell at you.
Oh, I don't care if you yell at me. I will walk away and pour my tea. I would say... You're so upset.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I would say Bond is higher than Buffy.
I want to make one argument for Buffy, seriously.
Okay.
Which is... the Rogues Gallery of Buffy involves characters with arcs over multiple episodes, while most of the villains and Bonds are one and done.
Blofeld isn't.
Blofeld isn't, and Jaws isn't. Because Jaws likes to just hang around and be silly.
So, I'll let Buffy be over Bond, just so you don't cry yourself to sleep
later. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Bond versus Dead by Daylight. Tough.
Yeah, because it's...
tough in an unfair way.
You know what? I'm gonna get real actually here.
Yeah.
Bond over Dead by Daylight? Dead by Daylight's gonna fall, because if you're just considering them in Dead by Daylight and not them in their original franchises...
okay.
Which could also hurt Sora.
Well, I will say for Dead by Daylight, like, the lore of that character is what puts them in Dead by Daylight.
Except for Ghostface.
True.
Because of the legal issues surrounding Ghostface.
Yeah.
Here comes the trouble.
Ginger snaps.
Samination just saved Dead by Daylight.
All right, you want to move it up?
No, it can stay. It can beat Bond.
It beats Bond. Does it beat Buffy?
No.
Okay. Bond versus Superman.
Bond.
I can agree with that. Superman versus Sherlock Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes.
Okay. Sherlock Holmes versus Bond.
Sherlock Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes versus Dead by Daylight.
Sherlock Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes versus Buffy.
I would say Sherlock Holmes, but I think you're going to poop your pants if I do that.
I have it. I'm locked and loaded and ready to poop.
All right. I'm going to give you...
all right.
I'm going to give you this so that you...
I'm happy with that stuff. Superman versus John Cena.
John Cena.
Yeah.
John Cena is Superman.
I know. I'm glad they stayed together. John Cena versus Bond.
John Cena.
Right? John Cena versus Dead by Daylight?
Dead by Daylight. Okay. John's hit a ceiling.
Bond already beat Superman. Superman versus Captain Hammer?
Superman.
Yeah. Captain Hammer versus Thor.
Thor.
Captain Hammer versus Kratos.
Captain Hammer.
Really?
I don't like God of War.
Okay. Kratos versus Ninja Turtles.
Ninja Turtles.
Ninja Turtles versus Captain Hammer?
Ninja Turtles.
Okay, does that mean that Ninja Turtles rise up to forces be reckoned with? Captain Hammer moves down to putting up a fight.
Yes.
We're moving...
Turtles up, Hammer down.
Oh, both. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Turtles versus Thor?
Thor.
Okay. Kratos versus Mal Reynolds. Captain Tight Pants.
Captain Tight Pants.
Kratos, you're going to fall.
Yep.
Tight Pants versus Captain Hammer.
Tight Pants.
All right. Tight Pants versus Turtles.
Pure, like... I don't ever remember anything Shredder does, but Shredder's iconic.
Yeah.
But...
and Super Shredder's Kevin Nash.
Yeah, like... I gotta let Shredder have it.
Okay, we can move Tight Pants up to first and regular one. All right, cool. So he'll be the top or put up a fight. Sounds good. Kratos versus Austin Powers.
Austin Powers.
Right. Austin Powers versus Captain Hammer.
Austin Powers.
Austin Powers versus Tight Pants.
Austin Powers.
Austin Powers making their way up this list.
Yeah, like, Austin Powers kind of actually had the detriment of being early.
Yes. I get you, and we were still feeling stuff out. Austin Powers versus Turtles.
Austin Powers. No, wait. Yeah, no, Austin Powers.
Really? All right, so we're moving him out of Put Up a Fight
into
Force to be Reckoned With to take on Thor.
Thor.
Yeah, I think Krasus versus Captain Kirk.
Captain Kirk.
Captain Kirk versus Captain Hammer.
Captain Hammer.
Okay. Kratos versus Captain Planet.
I can hear how sad you are when you know I'm about to say Captain Planet.
Captain Planet versus Kirk.
Kirk.
Okay. Kratos versus Darkwing Duck.
Kratos.
All right. Darkwing Duck versus the Power Rangers.
Power Rangers.
All right, here we go with another run here. Power Rangers over after Kratos.
Power Rangers.
Captain Planet?
Yes.
Captain Kirk?
You know what? Yeah.
Oh, making a run are the Power Rangers right now. Captain Hammer?
No.
All right, we'll drop you right there.
On the Rise is a banger.
Yeah. We drop down to our pushovers. So it's Darkwing Duck versus Scott Pilgrim.
Scott Pilgrim.
All right. Scott Pilgrim moves up or Darkwing Duck moves down?
Darkwing Duck can move down.
All
right. And Scott Pilgrim can move up.
Okay, both.
Yeah.
Now Scott Pilgrim versus Kratos.
Scott Pilgrim.
Captain.
Yeah, throw Kratos down.
All right.
Okay. I don't care.
He's going to go. Okay, Kratos deals with a bunch of pushovers, which are the gods of the world.
Well, you didn't have to do this.
Scott Pilgrim versus Captain Planet.
Scott Pilgrim.
Captain Kirk.
Captain Kirk.
Okay. All right. So, I think we're going to move a lot of stuff. Venture Brothers over Darkwing Duck?
Yeah, Venture Brothers over Darkwing Duck.
And then over Kratos?
Yeah.
All right. And below Captain Planet?
Sure.
Okay. Darkwing Duck versus the Ghostbusters?
Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters, all right.
At least you, like... people can't name a Darkwing Duck villain. I can, but yeah. Most people.
And then I assume the Ghostbusters then move past Kratos and stop at the Venture Brothers.
Yeah.
Earthworm Jim versus Darkwing Duck?
Darkwing Duck.
Okay. Mega Man versus Earthworm Jim? I'm happy where that is.
Okay.
Ash Ketchum versus Mega Man?
Ash Ketchum.
You want to move Ash up?
I can at least name Jesse and James.
Yeah. We'll move them up.
Prepare for trouble and make it double.
I'll move them past Earthworm Jim. Move past Darkwing Duck.
Which one's moving?
Ash Ketchum.
Yes.
And we're going to stop Ash at Kratos because he's the god of war.
I would totally put Team Rocket over Kratos if given half a chance.
There's only so far. I'm willing to go with a 10-year-old boy as Giovanni. You know what? As Giovanni. I'm moving past Kratos.
See?
There you go. But I think we can stop Ash Ketchum at the Ghostbusters.
Yeah. It is getting so warm in here.
I know. We're going to blow through this.
I'm starting to think.
Mario over Mega Man. I would say so. Over Earthworm Jim. Over Darkwing Duck. Over Kratos.
Yep.
What about Ash?
No, I like Team Rocket.
Okay, cool. Carmen Sandiego, you're getting dropped to the bottom. So we have Earthworm Jim, then Mega Man, then Bugs Bunny, then Rescue Rangers, then G.I. Joe, then Carmen Sandiego. I think that's right.
Okay.
And then our Luke Tipple tier is us over Sonic.
Yeah.
And then Sonic's over Rocky, then Rocky's over Scooby, and at the very bottom we have the American Gladiators.
Sounds good.
Cool! Thank you so much for joining us for this fantastic Crowdfund Crypt where I only lost my mind twice. And thank you so much for being patrons and hanging out with us. Our cream of the crop are Batman, Sora, X-Men, Luke Skywalker, and the Powerpuff Girls. And once again, the day is saved.
Yeah!
Thanks to Stay Doomed. Thanks for being patrons.
Yay!
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.